Hello, my name is Svan. I'm with the 3D scanning company Holocreators, and today I want to talk about a new idea that we had. It's the combination of two 3D scanning techniques, photogrammetry and computer tomography. I know these are like giant words, but I think to most of us they mean something. Photogrammetry, again, is a technique where you have an object in the center, and then you take photographs of that object from different angles and perspectives, and then that is calculated into a 3D model. And the other technique is computed tomography. That's CT scanning. Probably know that from the hospital, but in an industrial application, it's also an object in the center, and then X-rays are made, and then you calculate these X-rays into a 3D model. So we had the idea to combine both, because both techniques have their advantages. Photogrammetry has the advantage that you get most foremost colors, so you get a very nice 3D model with color and also a decent surface. And computer tomography has the advantage that you get a very highly accurate 3D scan. It has no colors, but it's very accurate, and it has all the scales in there, and you can also look inside the object, which is very attractive. So our idea is to combine both. So for this project, we worked together with Fraunhofer IIS. That's a research facility here in Germany for CT scanning. And they're actually in Bavaria, so it's quite a drive from here. But anyhow, they have a walk-in CT scanner down there. So normally, a computer tomography scanner, it's like a machine, and you put your thing in there, and then you close the door, and then it's scanned. But with them, they have like a room. So a room with it's almost like a bunker, and you can walk inside. You can set up your object and then close the door, and the X-rays are made. I want to talk about the recording setup. So for this project, we started with a running shoe, and you can see it there on the turntable, set up, prepared to get scanned. First, the photogrammetry setup. It's three cameras, three perspectives. At the moment, they're pretty low tier, but if it works with them, we can always upgrade. And the shoe sits on a turntable. We make three pictures with the three cameras. Then we turn the table about 15 degrees, make another set of pictures until we gun all around the way. And in the end, we will have a picture set of about 72 pictures, which are then piped into a software like Reality Capture and turned into a 3D model with color from that shoe. So next is the scanning of the shoe with the computer tomography scanner. And because we are already inside the room, inside the CT scanner, we just leave the shoe on the turntable, and everybody just goes outside the room, closes the door, and then it's X-rayed. This particular CT scanner is not like the one you might encounter inside a hospital. It's much stronger. So they actually told me a story. If you were to be inside that room while they make a CT scan, you can like discount 1 year of your lifetime. It's such a strong X-ray emitter in there that it's really not good for humans. So once the door is closed, everybody moved outside the scanner. It started, and you can see there on the screen how the model is X-rayed from different perspectives. Like I told you, the shoe remains on this turntable, and it's turned in increments about, I don't know, I would say 0.3 degrees. And what you end up is about 1,200 images, X-ray images, section views of this shoe, which are then piped into a software and calculated into a 3D model. The final step of the project is the fusion of both data sets. So we have the 3D scan with color from the photogrammetry setup, and we have the 3D scan from the computer tomography scan. And now we fuse them both. Best off for that is probably ZBrush. So pipe in both scans. And then what we did is just project the color information from the photogrammetry scan onto the computed tomography scan. Then some decimation, and voila, maybe some cleanup also, but that was basically it.